Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. This is the most recent dev blog that's been announced today on the 26th of May, the USS Wyoming BB-32. So another vessel for the United States tech tree. It's a new battleship. Very simplistic in my opinion in comparison to some of the other stuff we have in the game, but it will help to fill out a little bit more in that Dreadnought battleship class that we have in the game currently. And it's always nice to see a little bit more. So this is the shit. I was talking about this on the server and it doesn't seem to fucking say anywhere in here, does it? No, unless it do, but I just haven't found it yet. This is the 1912 outfit of the ship. 1910. Completed a year later in September 1912. Yeah, okay. So there's a few different fits of this vessel. Including a training ship version that's basically an AA vessel. I was curious to know which one they were adding, and well, now we can actually see the ship in-game outside of the dev server that I haven't actually seen yet. So briefly, it is the last American battleship designed to be fitted with 12-inch guns, featuring impressive firepower and protection but lackluster mobility. It's the USS Wyoming. It's a battleship for the United States of the 5th rank. Pros: that it has numerous large-caliber guns, improved protection, high crew count. Cons: that it has low mobility and poor anti-air defenses. Boy, isn't that ironic. So here's some history on the unit. And here we have some screenshots of the vessel. I can see some seaplanes back there, and it's making me horny. Holy shit, look at that. Oh, that's epic. Those turrets look fucking badass. They look like Star Wars guns. In War Thunder, USS Wyoming will be a new battleship arriving at the top rank of the American naval tree as part of the next major update coming soon to the game. Succeeding the USS North Dakota, some seasoned captains already had the chance to command USS Wyoming. Already had the chance to command, USS Wyoming builds upon the familiar characteristics of its predecessor and offers its aspiring captains some notable improvements in firepower and protection. While still armed with what at first glance seems to be the same 12-inch, 305mm cannons found on USS North Dakota, USS Wyoming is fitted with an additional twin turret, thus increasing its total primary battery up to 12-inch guns and subsequently bolstering the warship's firepower. I like how I said up to 12-inch guns, but it's 12-inch guns. Fun fact, due to the ship frequently operating and being sighted in the Chesapeake Bay area, it gained the nickname Chesapeake Raider during its service. Furthermore, USS Wyoming also features a reinforced secondary battery consisting of 16 5-inch, 127mm cannons, with 8 guns mounted along each side of the ship's hull. USS Wyoming's anti-air protection has also been increased by a further 2 3-inch, 76mm cannons, increasing the AA defense up to 4 whole fucking guns in total. Despite this increase, the anti-air cannons only have a limited effectiveness against fast-moving aerial targets, meaning that aspiring commanders of this vessel still have to seek out assistance from other warships for good AA protection. Unlike USS North Dakota, USS Wyoming lost the ability to carry and launch torpedoes in the mid-1920s refit. Well, that doesn't tell me if this one is getting torpedoes or not. Are they adding the 1912 version or the 1920 version then? I'm assuming that because they said this, we're getting the 1920 version then. Okay. So here we got some more screenshots of the vessel. Nice and fat on its bottom. There you can see those seaplanes. While at a first glance, the armor protection on the USS Wyoming doesn't seem to differ much from its predecessor, possessing nigh identical armor values at its vital components, the warship did receive improved anti-torpedo protection in the form of enlarged torpedo bulges. Oh, no wonder it's got such a fat bottom. And the installation of torpedo bulkheads. As a result, the ship's survivability against torpedo damage increases, and when combined with the sizable complement of 1,242 sailors, makes the USS Wyoming a highly durable warship even during extended gunfights. On the other hand, the increased firepower and protection also increased the ship's displacement. As a result, a more powerful 43,187 horsepower steam propulsion system is installed to maintain a top speed of 21.4 knots or 39.6 kilometers an hour. The USS Wyoming is expected to dick in player ports with the arrival of the next major War Thunder update and will succeed the USS North Dakota at the top rank of the American naval tree in the game. In the meantime, keep a close watch on the horizon for more news regarding the upcoming major update. Red skies, until then, calm seas, and happy hunting, Keeptons.